even we can call this renewable resources as non-exhaustible resource, means it never gets exhausted after the usage. But this one, what happens, it is a exhaustible resource. Why? Means after the usage it gets exhausted, hence we say that as what? Non-renewable resource. Okay, then we have another classification of this natural resource, isn't it? What is that? That is biotic factor and abiotic factor. You might have come across, isn't it? Natural resources can also be divided into two ways: biotic factor and another one is abiotic factor. Okay, what do you mean by this biotic factor? What do you mean by bio? Generally, bio means what? Living. Jeeva iro antadu alva. So biotic factor means what then? It includes the living things, isn't it? That is known as what? Biotic factor. Then what do you mean by this abiotic factor? Abiotic. A means what here? Absence of living nature. That is, we call it as what? Non-living things. This is what? Non-living things. Bio means what? Living. So it is living factors, or we call it as living beings or living things. Bio means what? Living. So living beings or living creatures. Okay, then abiotic, absence of living. A antidalva. So absence of living nature or living creatures can be called as what? Abiotic factors, that is non-living things. Then what are the examples you can take for this? See, for biotic factors you can take what? Plants, trees, human beings, etc. Then for non-living thing you can take it as what? The examples as air, then water, heat, etc. Okay, then you might have come across there is a scarcity of resources in our economy. Why the scarcity arises in the economy? I said that there is a unlimited human want, but there is a limited resources, hence the scarcity of resources arises. Then apart from this, tell me which are the different factors that is leading to the scarcity of resources. Scarcity of resources. Why this scarcity of resources is happening here in our economy, means it might be due to the various factors what we will be discussing now. It might be due to the overpopulation. Overpopulation means huge population. See, nowadays what's happening is the population size is increasing to a very greater extent. So as a result, what happens? The availability of resources among the people is less, but the need of people is increasing. As a result, it will lead to what? Scarcity. Okay, then other thing is growing industrialization. Growing industrialization means what's happening is nowadays there is a wide increase in the industries, in the number of industries. So as a result, the proper allocation of resources cannot be made among all the industries. At that time, what happens? There will be a scarcity of raw materials among the industries, that is among the manufacturers. So even that is one of the factor which is leading to a scarcity of resource, we can say. Then expanding urban areas. What do you mean by urban area? See, urban area means where a huge population lives in a small place can be termed as what? Urban area. Alva. So ega urbanization jasti agibittide. Expanding the urban areas means you can see even in a faraway area of that urban area, you can see number of people are leading their life. So what happens there means it also leads to what? Scarcity of resources. Okay, Atmospheric pollution, it is also another factor which lead to scarcity of resources. What do you mean by atmospheric pollution? What do you mean by pollution? Pollution means what? Contamination. Okay, so here atmospheric pollution means it says that it is a contamination of air. Air gets polluted. Alva? ಗಾಳಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಲಿನ್ಯ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಯಾಕೆ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ ಅಂದರೆ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಮೋರ್ ಯೂಸೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆಹಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ನವ ಡೇಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈವನ್ ದ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಿಲೀಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪಾಯ್ಸನಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಮೇ ಲೀಡ್ ಟು ವಾಟ್ ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫಿಯರಿಕ್ ಪೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್. ಸೊ ಆಸ್ ಅ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ಏರ್ ದೇರ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಪೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಡಿಗ್ರೇಡೇಷನ್. Even water pollution and even the land degradation is also another factor which is leading to the scarcity of resources. Water pollution, how does it happen? See, the dumping of waste particles in the water and even the industries may leave the poisonous or polluted water into the canal. So like that. So as a result, what happens? The water pollution may takes place. Then after this, you might have come across a concept like conservation of resources, means how to conserve the resources. See, to conserve these resources we have 4R strategies, isn't it? Conservation of resources, 4R strategies, that is what? Reuse, reduce, like that. So let me write that: reduce, reuse, regenerate, regenerate, and another one is research. So by using these 4 R's, that is reduce means as much as possible reduce the usage of natural resources so that you can protect it in a proper way. Then reuse. See, don't use the resource only for one usage. You can have a multiple usage of this natural resource. So do it, manage it properly. Then regenerate means what? Try to regenerate the resources what you have used. Okay. For example, for regenerate, when it's raining, you can store this rainwater in a proper way and you can have a usage of it. That is what regenerate. Also, it can be called as recharge. Recharge. Then research means search it again and again so that you can come out with the natural resources or resources. Okay. Solar or wind energy is a renewable alternative to energy that we use. That is research. You can have a very inventions, very more inventions to use the resources in a different way. So these are the 4 R's where you can conserve the resources in a proper way, isn't it? Then you might have come across the concept like human resources of India. What do you mean by human resource? See, even the human beings are considered as one of the resource in our country. Not only in country, in the world, we are considering the human beings as one of the resources in our economy. Because people are the one who will use the available raw material, isn't it? Will use the resources properly and they will be converting the input into output in a proper way. So human resources are very much important in India. So here we are considering the people as one of the resource, means the people are nothing but what? The employees of an organization, we can say. That is, nowadays we are using the term like human resource. Human resource andre eno? Company alli kelsa maartiddan kelsa maartiroru alva. So human resource occupies a greater importance in the production of goods and services. Okay. Then we might have studied about characteristics of India's population. How this India's population is means it is having a large size of population. In India, there is a increase in the population size every day, isn't it? Then second stage of demographic transition. What do you mean by this here? Demographic transition means where the death rate is lower than the birth rate. Okay, demographic transition means what here? The birth rate is more than the death rate. What is happening in our country is also same thing. So as a result, the population size is increasing very much in our country. Okay, then we have unfavorable climatic condition, we can say. Okay, means there is a no favorable climatic conditions here. What do you mean by this? See, as there is an increase in the population size, what's happening? People are destroying the forest area. They are polluting our climate. So as a result, it is leading to what? Environmental pollution also. So people cannot have a proper good health, we can say, to some extent. Then predominance of rural population. Even the rural population is more in our country. Then we have low literacy rate in our country. Yes, isn't it? Literacy rate means what? It gives the value of the people, how many are literate, how many are educated, isn't it? It is less when compared to other countries. Then low level of education and training. We find only few people who are educated and who are having a very good training. Okay, low life expectancy means life expectancy rate is also decreased, means number of years how to what extent a person can live, isn't it? Then so we can say that there is a overpopulation in our country, isn't it? Then you might have come across the different concepts like backward country, developing country and developed country. What do you mean by this backward country? Backward country means there, it says that there is a high birth rate and death rate, so low population growth rate. Backward country means what happens there? There is a high birth rate and high death rate. So as a result, there is a less population growth in such a condition. Then another one is developing country. What do you mean by this developing country? Here you will be having a high birth rate and low death rate. Birth rate jaasti irutte, death rate enagirutte kadme agirutte. Hagagi enagutte alli, there is a high population size in such a country. Then developed country. What do you mean by this developed country? Here what happens is there is a low birth rate and low death rate. As a result, it will lead to what? Low population rate in such a nation. Okay. So what are the different indicators of health? You might have studied about the indicators of health. What are those indicators of health? It will be telling about what? Life expectancy, infant mortality rate, child mortality rate, maternal mortality rate, isn't it? See, when all these different indicators are in a proper way, what happens? We can say that it will be having a very good human development index value that you will be studying in a PUC level. Okay, so that you will be, you can say that a human resource is managed in a proper way. Then after this, you might have come across the concept like poverty, isn't it? What do you mean by poverty? As I said that poverty is one of the social problem that is existing in our country. Poverty means what? It's a situation where the people are unable to get the basic needs like food, shelter, clothing, isn't it, etc. So that is known as what? Poverty. Then what are the causes of this poverty? Causes might be what? It is due to more population size, isn't it? That is rapid increase in population, you can say. Low level and growth of national income. The national income might be less than the rise in the price level. See, when there is an increase in the price of the goods, what happens? People are unable to afford that and they cannot get the goods or a service. Even the food they cannot purchase, isn't it? So it may lead to what? Poverty. Then unemployment. Unemployment means people are unable to get the job. So what happens on their life? When they are unable to get a job, they cannot get money at all for usage purpose. So that is unemployment here. Then capital deficiency, etc., isn't it? Then You might have come across the poverty alleviation programs also, like what economic development measures means the government should take a proper measure to remove this poverty. Then implementation of poverty eradication programs means what are the different programs that we can understand or use in order to remove, eradicate means what? Remove this poverty problem from our country. That is self-employment programs you can take, or IRDP, that is Integrated Rural Development Program. Then SGSY, that is Swarna Jayanti Gram Swarojgar Yojana. Okay, this will be studying in our PUC also. Then Swarna Jayanti Shahari Rozgar Yojana, then National Rural Livelihoods Mission, etc. Isn't it? Apart from this, we have wage employment programs also to remove this poverty from our society. Okay. Then you might have come across a concept like labor and employment. What do you mean by labor? Labor means a person who will be working. Isn't it? So, labor, we mean the capacity to exercise physical or mental effort for the purpose of producing goods or service. Labor means a person who is working in an organization or in a workplace. Why? Means to produce some kind of good or a service, or to complete a certain task. You know, work maadbekappa, ond vastu tayar maadbeku athva ond seve yene agirbodu alli namige word en barutte, labor. But nowadays in the companies, even in the organization, we never use the term labor. Almost we'll be using them as what? Employees, because employees are the main pillars of any organization to get succeeded, because they are the main resource of a company. Hence we call them as what? Human resource. Okay, they are given very importance. Then you might have studied about the importance of labor. Okay, then you might have come across what is unemployment and why does it happen. See, unemployment arises due to various factors, among that increase in the population size might also be one of the reason or cause. And another thing is jobless growth. See, people are unable to get a job at all. When there is a huge population, for whom to allocate the work then? Then increase in the labor force, inappropriate technology. Sometimes what happens is people are unaware of the recent techniques or technology what the company is using. That may also lead to this unemployment problem. So the people should update themselves. Okay. Then dependence on agriculture. More people are depending on agriculture. Then decline of small scale and cottage industries. Low mobility of labor. And even you might have come across the programs which can be used to generate the employment in India, like Food for Work program, training rural youth for self-employment. Okay, this is implemented in rural areas, whereas in urban areas, if you take Nehru Rozgar Yojana, okay, then scheme of urban wage employment, Swarna Jayanti Shahari Rozgar Yojana, etc. Okay, so these are the topics you might have come across in your high school level. So again, you will have a little bit of continuity of these topics, and along with that, some more information you will be studying in the first PUC of economics. That we will be discussing in the next class. I'll continue in the next class. Okay, thank you.